Dear students, assalamu alaikum. I hope you would be safe and sound inside your homes. Yesterday, unlock 5 guidelines came on the surface. It is still ambiguity whether schools will remain open or they will remain shut. It is something like voluntary basis you have to attend school. If you are fit, you are healthy, you are not having any sort of infection, you come to the school and do attend classes, and also you can receive the guidelines, counseling from your teachers so that you can crack the coming examinations with ease. Dear students, the pandemic has caused a great damage to your academic health, to your academic side, but the extra efforts or extra hard work can compensate these things. I have already told you many a times that hard work and self-study can take your sinking boat to the bank. One more important thing is that you must remain psychologically motivated. Psychological motivation is important. If some sort of a tension is circulating in your mind that I may cross not the examinations, the coming examinations, this would put you in a high risk of getting depressed. So better is to leave all psychological tensions. There is only 70% that would be asked in the board examination. Rest 30% concession is there or rejection is there. Dear students of class 10th, today we are dealing how the nationalism became the cause of imperialism. So you might be knowing that nationalism is when there is extreme love for a nation, or the oneness is there, fraternity grows there, every individual is working for the nation, for the prosperity and peace of the nation, and something like that. Our nation should have the pride or have should overlap other nations in terms of economic stability, in terms of political stability, in terms of cultural spirit. These all things we can collectively call as a nationalism, or we can sometimes say the nationalism is the extreme love to the nation. And when there are feelings that we belong to one nation, our aim is to build a nation, to go for the prosperity of a nation, to go for the economic stability of the nation, and our pride is our nation. These things come to the mind of the people, simply nationalism grows there. Their students, during the later half of the 18th century, the Industrial Revolution took place, and it did start from the United Kingdom, England, and within short duration of time, it spread to the whole world. So in most Europe, the industrialization took place, and there were factories were in plenty or in enough, the things were produced in enough. So for selling these products, the European countries need markets and also the raw material. For that, finally felt a need, we should go for those countries where the industrialization has never taken place, and which are economically or politically or socially or culturally backward. So the European countries came to the Asian countries and as well as the African countries as the traders, for selling their products and getting the raw material for their factories to run, for their industries to run. But day by day, when they saw the people of Africa as well as the people of Latin America and Asia, they are the backward people, they started them dominating socially. And when socially a particular country is dominated, it's colonialism. And with the passage of time, they dominated them politically because they were rich in every aspect. They taking the advantage of their backwardness in economy and political spheres, and other seafarers, they start dominating them, and finally they dominated them and the imperialism came in. But there should be nationalism, because extreme love for the nationalism, these things promote that we should have the economic stability, we should go for the prosperity of a nation, the people there was a feeling like that. So this nationalism became the cause of imperialism in most countries. So when people start thinking about the nation for its prosperity, for its stability, and every sphere, they go for the every development of a nation, they put everything for the nation, automatically this nationalism promotes the imperialism, because without the support of the people, without the nation building, without the this nationalism, this imperialism may not come. So when the nationalism started in Europe, it was extreme. Sometimes it's called chauvinism. So extreme nationalism, the people went to the greater extent for the nation, to do everything for the nation. The fraternity, brotherhood, everything was developed, and this finally made Europeans to develop their ties with the rest of the world, and then to dominate them socially as well as the politically. So the nationalism is the cause of imperialism, and also the nationalism in India later on changed the India's destiny, because there was oneness and people, fraternity and people got united, and finally the British surrendered the powers before the Indians. When nationalism grew here, it finally made British to surrender their powers. Initially during the 18th century, this nationalism also was the cause of imperialism in most countries. Dear student, this is all about, or we can say this is the brief introduction, how nationalism was the cause of imperialism. Better is to see these things on your available book. If any sort of query strikes your mind, you can call me. I am available around the clock for you. But self-study and hard work, having no substitution at all, you must put extra efforts, you must do extra hard work to crack these examinations, because it is the 21st century, competition is at the peak. With 50% marks or 40% marks, your fate can't be built. So better is to put extra effort so that you can get a nice percentage of marks and would win the race in these days of competition. Thanks, be well, I said.